To inspect the country's preparedness in terms of ICT infrastructure, the team from government ministries, departments and agencies was led by the ICT and National Guidance Minister, Chris Bariomonsi, the Executive Director of the National Information Technology Authority, Dr. Atweeb Mogasa, and the Managing Director of Uganda National Roads Authority, Allen Kajina, and many more, starting with Entebbe International Airport.
We basically came to appreciate the work which has been going on in the last 1 month or so to make sure that we have efficient connectivity here at the airport. And we shall be proceeding to the other places and ending up with Munyonyo in preparation for NAM and the G77 plus China summits. But also, like Collins has said, yes, we have fixed these services, but they're not going to go away with the summits or the delegates. The services shall remain here.
The inspection was guided by the general manager of the airport, Emmanuel Barunji, from the ordinary wing, the VIP and the VVIP sections, where NITA Uganda has installed free internet connectivity on reception at the airport, for which Uganda Civil Aviation Authority is grateful.
As you can see, if you are checking your gadgets as you are moving around, indeed the network has really improved greatly. And to me, it's very good news because it's not only for the conference, but it will be here to serve all our customers that go through this airport. And therefore, it will improve our rating as an airport.
According to UNRWA's Managing Director, Allen Kajina, they worked in partnership with all stakeholders to ensure they leave space for movement of utility cables while constructing modern roads that has enabled internet connectivity without spoiling the road infrastructure.
Anita, you, for what we have seen today, the connections, the installations for connecting the airport, and I'm told the route on the way to Munyonyo. A lot of us, I think, have been unaware of how much work has been going on. And just to be here and to see the instant connection once you get into the network field is really, really good. So congratulations, NITA, you. And you build the virtual network, we build the physical network. And today I've seen how we can actually integrate these two networks to allow connection of our people.
The internet infrastructure around Kampala has cost the government 3.2 billion shillings.
Costed NITA Uganda 3.2 billion Ugandan shillings. But put in mind that this is infrastructure that's going to last for more than, for about 7 to 10 years. So it's not a one-off. It is infrastructure that's going to be permanent and utilized by the government of Uganda.
And space for such services, such as ours, telephone, fiber, and so we're glad to you know, partake of that provision.
From Entebbe International Airport, the team had a guided tour in the areas of Kajansi, where there are NITA Uganda optical fibers, and later to the convention center at Munyonyo. Inspection at Munyonyo was guided by the chairperson of the Parliamentary Committee on ICT, Engineer Moses Magogo. Report by Ismail Nsubuga for the news.